organizations that enable AI into their analytics process are 2 times more likely to report significant value from their data initiatives compared to those that don't. Welcome to a special edition of the AppDevANGLE, live from the Open Source Summit North America 2025. My name is Paul Nashawaty. I'm the practice lead and principal analyst at the AppDev practice here at theCUBE Research. And today I'm joined by Naveen from Truxt.ai. Naveen, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Paul, thank you for having me here.
Great to have you on. Why don't you tell the audience a little bit about yourself and the company?
Sure, I'm a founder and CEO of Truxt.ai, and our predominant expertise is DevOps, but then we have developed an enterprise analytics platform for business leaders and engineering leaders to help them reduce their software development time and cost. So a lot of AI involved, and I would love to talk in details how this works.
That's fantastic, great to have you on. This is it's really, really important for enterprises today. We see there's a growing pressure to turn data into actionable insights, right? We see that by integrating AI into the analytics workflows, that organizations are transforming decision making decisions here to unlock the new levels of automation, prediction, and strategic agility, right? That's really a big part of where organizations are moving. So let's jump right in. When we look at Truxt, and we understand that the comprehensive AI-powered analytics platform, it's really designed for those enterprise businesses. Why did you think to form this company?
Well, my previous background is DevOps and software engineering intelligence. And we found that engineering leaders love the golden standard of measuring their software development lifecycle processes, which is DORA, right?
Yeah.
The good thing about DORA is it tells you what is happening in your organization in terms of software development lifecycle. But leaders want why is something happening. For example, through DORA, they get to understand that my deployment frequency is 5 days. But then they want to understand why is it 5 days and how can we reduce it from 5 days to 3 days.
Right.
And if we keep continuing how we are doing, how my next quarter looks like. So these are some of the questions where I found engineering or business leaders to spend a lot of time.
Yeah.
And what is the other way to solve it? You will have business analysts or data analysts put together all those Looker reports, which takes a week or two of time.
Sure.
And then they produce it to their business leaders on the basis of which they make a decision. We saw this is taking a lot of time.
Sure.
And this time can be significantly reduced. And the whole analytics part or the analysis part itself, which a business analyst or a data analyst does, can be significantly reduced. And that's where I happen to build my AI analytics platform.
Well, I think it sounds really interesting. I mean, I think that the market, and sort of specifically around DevOps, is really challenged with, basically the business KPIs say push code out the door fast, right? Just kind of get your KPIs done. And the problem is measuring those results can often be a challenge for organizations. DORA, of course, is near and dear to my heart. I cover DevOps in my practice. Mm-hmm. I mean, I cover the app dev practice, so this is like really, really in my wheelhouse. But when I think about, the metrics, and I think about whether it's DORA or space or whatever it may be that kind of look and understand how things are measured here. What specifically is helping accelerate the agility of the DevOps teams with regards to understanding those metrics versus traditional ways of kind of pushing the code out the door fast without really having to measure?
So there are two parts to it. The first part of it is getting to understand how you're doing itself. And trust me, enterprises get surprised by some of the uncoveries we do.
Sure.
So that's the first part. I need to understand how my setup is, how am I doing? And then the second part is the way I am doing, what are the top three things, what are the three easiest things we can change to make a broader impact on our software development lifecycle? And this can be driven from leaders, or this can be driven from managers, or developers at the very ground level itself. So these are the two different ways we found where knowing DevOps metrics and then bringing in some of those practices once you understand the deficiencies can make a significant difference.
Yeah, that makes sense. When I think about it, organizations that are not using these measurement tools, are they not using them because they slow down the CI/CD process and the pipeline, or are they kind of not mature enough to understand what they need to be looking for. What do you advise the audience listening to, like, hey, this is something that you really should like put in place so you can go faster?
Right, so in my view, large enterprises are really large and huge in the way they do their software development lifecycle. And there are so many teams which are inconsistent in the way they produce software. So DevOps metrics setup is the first thing they should be able to do.
Yep.
Second part of it is now with AI, things are becoming much more easier. And if I break down into a few layers, one, you already are using different DevOps tool suites, Jenkins, GitHub,
yep.
And then agile tools like Jira's of the world. With AI, now you can seamlessly integrate with these much easily compared to how it used to take. So no more clunky connectors, you can do it much easier with MCPs or function callings of the world today. Second is, people were not investing a lot of time in analyzing all the data they're collecting.
Right.
AI helps you there too. So now you can not only collect all these metrics, but you can do a lot of correlation, a lot of analysis. So the heavier part of analysis is now taken care of.
Yeah, absolutely.
And third part is with the evolution of agentic AI, you do not need to spend a lot of cost or effort on data analytics or data analysts. Agents can do a lot of great work for you. So the threshold of how it has been to how it has become now is significantly getting reduced in this fundamental change.
Yeah, I agree. I think that the introduction of using AI accelerates the adoption of those actionable insights. Historically, connectors allowed you to do something similar, but not really. It was kind of like, you used the word clunky, right? I think that makes sense. It's like to connect these two systems together, sometimes the connection worked, sometimes it didn't. It didn't give a proper representation of the metrics in the organization. And then even if it did, at best you were getting a red, yellow, green metrics, right? You were saying, yep. things on, but then there was no like, what's happening here and how is it moving forward? So I think AI also powers the decision making, not just for the practitioners at the DevOps level and the app dev teams, but also for the business leaders. Would you agree with that?
A lot. So imagine, I could know otherwise using DORA that my lead time for changes is 5 days. But I didn't know why it is taking 5 days. Now I know from analysis that it is taking 5 days and where are the bottlenecks? I remove those bottlenecks and you can reduce the software development time. Now, software development is directly correlated with the business you do.
Yeah.
So if you are reducing the cycle time of your development processes, it impacts your business, it makes you more agile, it takes you to market faster. So, reduction in software or fine-tuning your software development process helps you improve your business margins, your go-to-market faster, so it significantly actually impacts your business outcomes.
Yeah, absolutely. Not too long ago, I ran an app dev done right summit, and part of that summit, we covered day zero build, day one release, day two operations, and DevSecOps, and we have new fresh research around that. All those areas align to the CI/CD pipeline and the SDLC and what's happening. And what we found in some of that research is we found that organizations that responded indicated that they want to release code on an hourly basis, right? Continuing to be a driving factor. Actually, what we found is 24% of organizations want to do this, but yet only 8% are able to do so. And part of the reason is they're not mature enough in their delivery cycle to understand how to use the tools like AI to optimize that software delivery, right? But when we look at the practical applications around AI and streamlining the entire software delivery process, can you expand a little bit more on that, on like why this is such a pain point for so many organizations?
Okay, so you mentioned, even if you go with latest DORA report of 2024, you'll find that it takes more than 8 hours for organizations to fix their outages or meantime for recovery, and that's for majority of the organization, okay? To the question which you had asked before, why it has taken so long, why not everybody's delivering every hour? the process itself is very difficult to set up.
Yeah.
You know, you have so many tools in the mix, and then you need to, every organization or every business unit of that organization handles things differently.
They do.
So bringing everything together for a team is difficult.
Yeah, we found in that same research, not to cut you off there, but we found in that research that 75% of the respondents indicate they use 6 to 15 different tools to understand what's happening in their ecosystem. So that's to your point, is there's so many different tools, so many different layers. But yeah, so I didn't mean to cut you off, but I think that that's a valid point there.
Right, so different business units, using different set of tool suites, how do you measure everything at an organization level? So somebody has to standardize that whole process. And standardization of whole process in many organizations takes a lot of time, effort, and then there are different priorities for them, right? So setting up DORA metrics or setting up typical DevOps process is complicated. Many organizations have achieved it. Many organizations are calculating DORA metrics and are getting some values out of it. Still a lot changes needed to be done. For example, there are organizations who are still doing quarterly deployments.
Right.
Now, even if you use DORA metrics, your quarterly deployments means your lead time for changes is three months.
Right, that's right, right.
So, it's a lot about the processes, the tool suites, and the prioritized way of doing things they have, but great organizations I have seen have taken this hard step. They have streamlined their tool suites, and they are measuring their DORA metrics. They are also planning to take a step further. Well, we are now checking the temperature through a thermometer, but we can also get a primary doctor to help us understand what are the vital signs for me to improve, and how can I not just understand what the temperature looks like, but prescribe how can I fix the problem.
Right.
So a lot of work is happening. Organizations are preferring to move there, and I think this is the best time because the bar has significantly become lower to get into this space.
Well, I agree with you. I think that there's absolutely room for improvement. Evolution is going to continue to occur. Final thoughts for the audience here. You know, we're here a year from now. We're at Open Source Summit, as you know. Lots of buzz around what we're talking about here, just around the metrics, and certainly the theme of people, process, and technology kind of play into this whole event here. A year from now, what do you expect to see?
We are seeing the changes happening in industry very fast. Yes, there are some very important learnings for enterprises on do's and don'ts. The great thing about this whole evolution is just don't wait for the best LLMs to come or the best tools to come. In very small pockets, you can start implementing some of the proven strategies and solutions already working together, and you can evolve from there. I believe from here to the next year, we will be in a much better place in the way automation in whole DevOps lifecycle can bring a lot of value to the engineering and business leadership.
Well, I couldn't agree more. Don't wait. I think that's the audience takeaway here is get started, get in on it, and start working. Naveen, thank you for your time. This has been great. Your insights into this has really been awesome. I really think it's great to have you on the show here today. I also want to thank the audience for a big thank you to y'all for tuning in here. We appreciate you being part of the AppDevANGLE community. That wraps up this episode, but we'll be back next Wednesday with another conversation that dives into tools, trends, and technology and talent that shapes the future of application development. Whether you're deploying at the edge, building an AI, or modernize your cloud stack, we've got you covered. So until next time, be sure to follow us on social. If you have any thoughts, questions, or just want to connect, you can always reach me at paulnn@siliconangle.com. Until next time, stay curious and stay busy.